I'll ask you how you're doing. I want you to say better than good and better than most. How you doing?
Better than good and better than most.
I know that's right. And sometimes even better than that, right? Earl Nightingale had a saying I like. He said, all of us are self-made, but only the successful will admit it. Now, I want you to repeat after me, please. We got to recondition our minds first. Let us say together, good things are supposed to happen to me. Yeah, write that down. I want you to say that to yourself every day. See, we live in a world where we believe that bad things are supposed to happen to us. And let me tell you something, ladies and gentlemen. It's very important that we begin to learn how to create wealth. I'm not talking about loving money. See, I believe the lack of money is the root of all evil. People are steal for money. People are killed for money. People go to jail for money. Every time the unemployment goes up, in those areas where the unemployment is high, that's where you have the highest incidence of crime and violence. Whenever the unemployment goes up 1% in our community, 10,000 children and women are battered. One, money makes a difference in your life. I never wanted to be rich. All I've ever wanted to do was to be comfortable. How many of you ever wanted to be comfortable? Raise your hands. Then I realized in order to be comfortable, you gotta be rich. An old friend of mine, Zig Ziglar, said, people say money won't make you happy, but everybody wanna find out for themselves. Rita Davenport said, money ain't important, but it's right up there with oxygen. And let me tell you something, fellas, even if you're as homeless as I am, if you got some money, women will find something cute on you. He got earlobe like Denzel, honey. Money makes a difference. Let me tell you what money does. Number one, it gives you control over your life. Write that down. Number two, it gives you options. Three, it allows you to live a life of contribution, to contribute to things that you feel strongly about. So here's the first step to accumulating wealth. If you expect to do it, write this down. You must be willing to do the things today others won't do, in order to have the things tomorrow others won't have. What are the things that others won't do? Number one, make discipline a major force in your life. How many of you know if you'd have been more disciplined, you'd be further along to reach your goals right now? Socrates said, the undisciplined life is an insane life. The road to life is straight and narrow because few there be that are willing to discipline themselves. Here's something else that most people won't do. Make it okay to fail. A lot of people, 85% of people, allow their fear of failure to outweigh their desire to succeed. Repeat after me, please. Anything that's worth doing is worth doing badly. Yeah, see, anything that's worth doing is worth doing right, as we have been taught, if you know how to do it. But if you don't know how to do it, it's worth doing badly until you get it right. Now write this down. You don't have to be great to get started, but you have to get started to be great. To me, my definition of success is doing what you love to do and find somebody to pay you to do it. So what do you love to do? And then explore ways in which you can earn a living doing that. Cooking, writing, painting, working with numbers, working with people. But the other thing that's important, faith to act on whatever your dream is. See, when you make a commitment, I'm going to become wealthy, when you make it important, when you decide I'm going to do it no matter what, life changes for you.
Nothing in life has built-in meaning. The greatest gift all of you have ever been given is life is meaningless. You are designed to give life meaning. The meaning you give to every situation, positive or negative, determines how you experience the effect of that situation in your life. Negative meaning in, negative effect out. Positive meaning in, positive effect out. Every single situation has the ability to serve double duty. You decide what effect it will have by the definitions you assign to it.
You see, you are free to choose every single moment that you can. Now, remember, this is actually a vibrational formula, not just a nice saying. Every single moment that you can, act to the best of your ability on whatever contains the highest amount of your excitement, joy, love, creativity, and passion. To the best of your ability, taking it as far as you can till you can take it no further. And do that and keep doing that, no matter how it looks, no matter what form it comes in, with absolutely zero assumption, insistence, or expectation as to what the outcome of that action ought to be. That's it. That's the formula. And if you just do that every moment that you can, I guarantee that when you get in that flow, it will lead you where you need to be led. You'll wind up exactly where you need to be, when you need to be there, with whom you need to be. And it will allow an explosion of ecstatic synchronicity in your life and create the effortless and joyful experience that you all say you desire. And it really is that simple as acting on that formula and knowing that if you do, you are using the basic structure of existence, and thus then it will support you in that positive experience in exactly the same way it has always supported you in any negative experience you chose to buy into as well. You see, you are free to choose.
Remaining in the positive state is what allows you to experience the positive result, regardless of how it appears. Don't fall into the training of automatically assigning a negative meaning to something just because you've been taught that that's what it must mean. Give it a positive meaning because you know that there is nothing that happens in your life but those things that serve you.
If you want lasting change, you've got to give up this idea of trying something. You got to decide you're going to commit to mastery. The only thing that's going to make you happy, my friend, in this year or any other, is to step up. It's to raise the standard. It's to discover what you're capable of and feel that incredible power pushing through whatever's holding you back and get to the other side of more of your true self. That's what this game's all about. Once you break through, then it just becomes a game. The breakthrough happens by conditioning your mind every day, by feeding it a role model or a story. It's putting yourself in a peak state when you follow through by getting physically strong. It's creating a little ritual of doing a little bit each day, and then you get momentum. But the most important thing of all, why? Why is it a must for you? It doesn't have to be you're against the wall, but it has to be something you're hungry for, because the only difference in people is hunger. And if you're not hungry, get around people that are hungry and something will hit you. If you don't like the way your career is or your business is, change it. If you don't like your body, change it.
Because successful people do what failures won't. You follow me on this? Yeah?
A leader is somebody who lives life on their terms, that you will never settle for less than you can be or share or give or create. It's not what we get that makes us happy, it's who we become. You gotta decide you're gonna commit to mastery. 80% of success in life
80% of achievement in business, 80% of almost anything that matters in your life is psychology, and 20% is mechanics. Your body, your mind, your emotion, but you can't maximize it when you're trying to fit in. And you can't maximize it when you live by everybody else's rules. I'm not saying don't be respectful. I'm just saying as a leader, you got to decide what you believe is right. And one thing I can tell you will always feel right, to never settle for less than you can be, do, share, or give. Who you spend time with is who you become. And getting yourself in proximity with people that are succeeding, even if you have to work for free for somebody, getting the environment around them, it rubs off on you. You begin to think like they think. You begin to see what the opportunities are. Our whole life is shaped by decisions. That's what we've talked about today, right? But there's three decisions you're making every moment you're alive. And the way you make these three decisions shapes your destiny. First decision we're all making every moment is, what are you going to focus on? What are you going to focus on? And the second question you got to decide every moment you're alive, and including this moment, what are you going to focus on? Second question is, as you're focusing on, what does this mean? What does it mean? And the bottom line on meaning is,